Hey guys, welcome back to FedEx Gaming's Redstone Tutorials. In this tutorial, we're showing you guys how to build a pig slash cow breeder and cooker. Now, I say that is because they're the exact same thing, except pigs just use slabs and cows use signs. So let's just show how these things work and then we can start building them. So over here we have some pigs, and you know, I should have taken out some items so I could feed my animals. So let me get out a few pigs like to eat carrots if you did not know, and cows of course still like to eat wheat. So over here we have our pigs, and then we have some adult pigs in there, some baby pigs, and then we have our pigs up top. So let's just cook these pigs real quick to show you how you cook them. So all we do is click this button, and you can actually leave this on and walk away and let your baby pigs just grow up and die. So once they are dead, you know, you see all the baby pigs are still alive in there. They will not go until they grow up. But then down in here, we have some pork chops in here and some pork chops in this one as well. Now, when you want to breed your pigs, all you do is click this button. Now, with the pigs, you can't breed them from down here. Like on the cows, you can breed them from down here. But since we have to use slabs there, you have to go up top to breed your pigs. So, of course, if I take some carrots and I go like this, we can breed some pigs. They'll make some babies. Boop, see, we're getting experience because there goes the baby. See, there goes the baby. So you get the gist of it. It's pretty much just like my cow cooker, except it just has these little slabs right here. Because people are always asking me, is there a way for me to just, you know, oh, there's a baby stuck in there. Get down there. Is there a way for me to make a pig cooker out of my cow cooker? Oh, that's not a baby. That's just an adult. I forget how big the and small the babies and the adults are. So there we guys go. And then for the cow cooker, it's the same old song and dance right here. You know, you click the button, the lava comes out, burns the adult cows. The baby cows at the bottom in the hoppers are absolutely fine. And obviously we could turn it off. And then on the inside, there's all our steak and leather. Here's all our steak and leather in here. I think the cows are way better than the pigs because the pigs don't really drop as much steak as cows do. they drop pork chops, but they still don't drop as much food as cows do. It's amazing. And then obviously if we click this button up here, the cool thing about the cow one is we can feed the cows from down here and make the babies right from here. Or we could come up top like in my other videos and feed the cows right here as well. And this will make babies and, you know, experience and all that good stuff. Give me the experience. So then once we turn that off, all we have to do is wait for our babies to grow up. And obviously, like I said, you can just turn on lava and then just walk away. You know, you just walk away and wait for the animals to grow up. And then they'll end up just, you know, burning and making... I know it sounds cruel. So let's just start building these things, guys. Very easy. I'm just going to build one of them and then show you how to modify to make the pig and the cow version one. All right, guys. So for this build, we're going to need a 5x3 spacing. What we're going to need for this is 2 hoppers, 3 dispensers, 3 redstone torches, 1 piece of redstone dust, 2 buttons, some blocks to actually make our entire cow cooker out of. I like to use... blocks like, you know, stained clay or something like that. And then you like using glass, so I gave the amount of glass you're going to need. You're gonna need at least 9 pieces of glass. We're also going to need 4 chests, 4 slabs. Now that's for the pig one, and we're gonna need 4 signs for the cow one. So we're gonna make the pig one first, and then for both of them obviously we're gonna need water and lava. So what I want you to start off by doing is taking out your block of choice and going right into the middle of your 5x3. So to get right to your middle, all you have to do is go to the bottom left and count over 3 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, and then count up 1 block, 1, and that should be the middle right there. Then we're going to come up 3 blocks in the middle. So 1, 2, 3, put a button here and a button here. Next, swing onto the backhand side, and the bottom button right here, we're going to put a piece of redstone dust, 2 blocks like that, a torch coming off both sides of the blocks, a block on top of your torches, boop and boop. Next, what I want you to do after you get these 2 torches in, put your dispensers in. Now, there's a little bit of a bug going on right now when you place your dispensers in. It kind of does this weird like thing where it automatically faces downwards. So that can get really annoying. So what you're gonna have to do is like face upwards like this and place it like that. So if you're putting your dispenser in and it's going like lopsided sometimes, it doesn't always happen, see? But as you see right there, it did it. If it does that, you know, just look up a little bit more and place it in like that. And then on this side, do the same exact thing, put a dispenser facing inwards. That's a weird bug, I know, but it tends to do that. And then we're gonna put a block here and a block here. And inside these 2 dispensers is where our lava buckets are gonna be going. So if you wanna put your lava in there right now, you can. Just be on the safe side and do not press that button. Do not press that button. Then on the top button right here, we're gonna place a torch off the back. And then just place a dispenser right above the torch facing towards us like that. And then inside this one, we can put our water bucket, but don't put that one in just yet. Don't put the water bucket in just yet. Next one I want you to do is come right above the dispenser and make a backwards R shape. So come up 1, 2, 3 and over, and do the same thing on this side. 1, 2, 3 and over. And then in the back, we could build up the wall all the way to our dispenser. Do the same thing on this side, build it up to our dispenser. Now you can go ahead and put your water in. There we go. Now, since this is our pig one, what we want to do is delete these two bottom blocks out. Then facing the outside block right here, we're gonna put a hopper going into the block. So make sure your hook's coming this way. Do the same thing on the side, put it going into this block right here, like that. Delete this block, and then we're gonna put two chests, one, two. Same thing on this side, one, two. And then on the inside right here, since this is our pig one, we're gonna be using slabs. So put a slab right above your hopper, and then put another slab right up here like that. This is gonna be for the pig one. Then just take your glass and put your glass in like this. There we go, bring that over, bring that down. And doop, there we go. So there we have our glass in, and then we can just take another row and bring it all the way around like this to hide all the redstone. So there is our pig cooker. So we got our water up here, and then we press the button again, it goes away, and our lava down here. Press it, the lava comes out, and the lava goes away. And then obviously, you know, I'm just gonna, since I'm on creative, I can easily just stick pigs in there right away. But what you're gonna have to do on survival is, you know, just make like a little staircase going up here, and then just use leads, which are little ropes, which are, they should look like this. There, where are they? Where are the leads? There they are. They should look like this. They're called leads, and then you just put it around the pig's neck and bring it up here and put them in the hole. So I know it sounds wrong. You don't have to tell me. So we're gonna drop some pigs in here. So let's get some piggies in here. Let's put six. I guess I'll put six. I don't know how many more I can spawn in this world right over here. So I'm gonna put six pigs in here, and then we're gonna get out some carrots. So let's see, where's the carrots at? I always forget where like the food and stuff is on creative. So we click the button. Our pigs start bouncing. We can go ahead and feed our pigs. You know, make some baby piggies. There we go. Make some baby piggies. We got one, two. We should have enough in there to make three. But you know, the more pigs you have, the easier it's going to be to feed them. And three. There we go. Got them all. So we click the button. The pigs will stop jumping around, and then all we have to do is click the lava button. It'll funnel over these pigs. I don't know why that one kept jumping up and down right there. So obviously, you know, if you see one just randomly jumping up and down, it's probably due to the water right there. So, you know, just wait for him to stop jumping like these ones did. I kind of just jumped the gun and threw the lava out there and killed them. But as you can see, they're not dying from the lava. They won't jump up and down. Once they stop jumping, they should stop. And once they grow up, they'll, you know, become pork chops for us. So I'll just show you really quickly that it's working. So let's throw an adult pig in here, an adult pig in here. Let's close this up. They're jumping up and down because I broke those blocks right there. And let's cook the adult pigs. There we go. And then inside this chest, we have pork chops. And inside this one, we have a pork chop as well. So now what I'm gonna do is gonna get rid of all these pigs. And then we're gonna do the whole cow one, because it's the exact same thing. You don't have to rebuild it or anything like that. Just the cow ones, all you need to do is just put signs in here. All right, guys, so now that the pigs are gone, I'm gonna show you how to set it up so it could be a cow cooker instead of a pig cooker, or you know, you can make this twice and have both. That's what I was expecting people to do. So all you need to do is just delete these half slabs right here, delete these half slabs up here, and put a sign here, a sign here, and then down here, we're gonna put a sign here, and a sign right here like that. And then all we have to do, you know, just replace the glass back in here. Put that in there. Here we go, and we're done. That's it. So now all we have to do is put some cows in there. Obviously, like I said, if you're on survival, you're gonna have to lead your cows up here, like up a staircase or something, to get up here to actually get them in the hole. But for me, since I'm on creative, I can just chuck a few cows in there. I put six cows in there. So when I'm right, actually, if you want to too, if you want to breed your cows from down here, you could switch out this middle glass block right here with a half slab upside down. So now you can breed your cows from down here as well. That's a good thing about this one. So if we click the button, our cows start bobbing up and down. Like I said, you can go ahead and feed them from down here if you really want to, or you can go up top like normally and, you know, just feed them from up here. So they should make some baby cows. There we go. We got one baby cow out of the six that are up there. There we go. I was wondering why they're not bobbing around as much as they usually do it. So there we go. We feed our cows, you know, make some baby cows. We can feed them from down here if we really want to. So we got two baby cows. I made enough in there to make three baby cows, but you know, I'm not gonna keep looking for that one that I'm missing. So we're gonna click the water, and as you can see, if I turn on my lava, the baby will stay alive until it grows up. And then obviously I could take the lava away, but we wanna see that it's actually working. So we're gonna crack this open and go all inhumane on this. And we're gonna close this up. and let's cook some cows. So click the button. The adults get cooked, the babies stay alive. There they go. And then inside our chest, there we have some steak, some leather, and some still cooked pork chops in there. And in here we have some steak, some leather, and cooked pork chops. So there you guys go. That's how you build my cow slash pig breeder and cooker. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave it a like and subscribe to stay tuned with my newest videos. All right, guys. Peace.